everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome back to Monsterfest 2017, and welcome to a very, very cool unboxing of this right here. A Dark Ascension Fat Pack from the original Magic the Gathering Innistrad set, or Innistrad block. Really, I am looking forward to this. In my total lifespan, I think I've opened maybe 4 or 5 packs of Dark Ascension. All of them have been in those little 3-packs that Walmart used to sell. It was like a pack of 3 random Magic the Gathering packs with a promotional card over the top of it, so you couldn't tell what the packs were. All you could see was like the side of the packs. But I happened to pull 4 or 5 of them over the span of being able to open some of these things. So I'm really looking forward to this. Now, what is in this set? I have absolutely no clue, and I mean no idea what's in this set at all. All I know is it's part of the Innistrad block, the original, so we're in for some amazing artwork. Maybe we'll pull that elusive whatever is expensive in this set. Probably nothing. And frankly, I don't really care. I just want to see some cool art to go with our Monsterfest theme here. And I get the feeling that we're going to find some right here in Dark Ascension. So let's jump back to the table and once again take a look at a Magic the Gathering Fat Pack. This time, Dark Ascension. Dark Ascension in a Fat Pack form. Boy, this is really cool for me, guys. This whole Monsterfest thing has been just an absolute blast. And as we come down to the wire in these last couple of weeks, we're hitting up some Magic sets that I unfortunately missed out on. And Dark Ascension's one of the two. The other one is next week's Innistrad, the original Innistrad. But I get the feeling we're going to find some very cool artwork in this set. I'm hoping so anyway. Honest to God, I have absolutely no idea what is in this set at all. I mean, I have no clue. I have opened a total in my lifetime of like 3 Dark Ascension packs. And all of those I was able to find back in 2013 or so when I first got back into Magic in like these little things that Walmart used to sell where it was a pack of 3 Magic card packs. But they had like a promo card over the top of it, so you couldn't actually see which packs you were getting. And if I recall correctly, I believe I got 3 of those, 3 Dark Ascensions in those packs. But let's jump into this thing. I guess I should read what's on the back of this. So we get a lot very similar to what we've seen in some of the previous packs here. We get 9 packs of cards. We get a player's guide. We have the card box, which I just pulled out. A 70-card basic land pack. 10 double-faced checklist, or 10 double-faced card checklists. Okay, so there's going to be flip cards in this set. Special edition spin-down life counter and 2 deck boxes. So, take out our piece of cardboard there. Here is our very rough, once again, very much like that Avacyn Restored, player's guide / card encyclopedia, whatever you want to call it. Look at that artwork. Oh, this is going to be so good. Oh, man. Okay, so we've got a checklist for all the cards, and then we've got pictures of all the cards over here as well. I guess I could look through them and try to figure out which cards are look cool or look like they'd be worth money. But hey, seriously, who cares, to be honest with you? We're here for artwork because this is just a sweet, sweet set. Wait, look at that. I love that blade. Look at that. It's like a blade that's twisting around itself and hollow in the center. Very cool. Man, so nice. Their top 10 cards, Wizards picks for the top 10 cards. There's Soren Markov, a little bit of history about him. Oh, wow. So cool. Man, I gotta tell you, this is exciting for me. Again, like the other one, on the inside, we have ourselves a, well, there you go, you can see it from that side. We have a little piece of art. It's actually very similar to the art on the front here, only, Soren's not wiping his blade off. It's, excuse me for yawning. He's drawn in a little bit more painterly style. I don't know if you can see that. I guess if I can kind of tilt it correctly, you can sort of see it a little bit. But very similar in style to the front of the little cover thing here. But set that to the side because I don't want to open that up. And here we have our card box. These things normally hold about 700 cards. And inside here, we're going to find two deck boxes. Again, have the set name on one side and some artwork from the set on the other side. Again, won't hold sleeved cards, but still not too bad, I suppose. And then we have our two packs of cards, and it looks like, just similar to the other one, the die has escaped. We have a green die this time with the Dark Ascension set symbol right there. Okay. So let's put this to the side. Okay, we'll set that die over there. All right, let's jump into this here. Boy, howdy. This is going to be fun. All right, so we've got a how to play guide right here. I think there's too much different on this one. It doesn't look all that different from the one from, I think it was Avison Restored had one of these. Yeah, so there's nothing set specific, doesn't look like, in this one. So we'll just fold that back up and again set that to the side too. Got some packs of cards here. Wow, three Saurons and a couple of werewolves. Alright. And then on this side we have the need of a hobby knife. I'd really like to get into this without cutting the packs or the land. So there we go. That's a good place to do it. Do a little surgery on my fat pack packaging. All right, here we go. And we'll set that to the side. Wow. So apparently, Dark Ascension only had two pieces of art for the cards, either that or I just got really unlucky and didn't find either the third or the fourth one. So, very interesting here. We'll just kind of do this with them. How about that? And so we've got four wolves and five Saurons. So let's open it. Saurin, wolf, Saurin, wolf, Saurin, wolf, Saurin, wolf, Saurin. Cool. And here we have a 70 card block of actual Innistrad lands. You can see that by the Innistrad set symbol right there. Let me zoom in just a little bit there. Like a crown. Alright. It might be two geese fighting each other, or facing away from each other. I don't know. But not gonna open this yet, because I don't know. Might be worth a little something. Maybe $5-6. Who knows? Those land packs are always worth a little bit. But ooh, I'm so excited. Alright, let's get into it. 9 packs to go. What kind of awesomeness are we going to find? I have no idea. Let me make sure that I am set up reasonably in the right spot. Back up slightly. Thank you. Alright. Let's do it, baby. Let's do it. Again, I have no idea what is in this set. I have no idea what's good. I think this is kind of like Homelands in that there's nothing good in this set. But that's okay, because again, I'm an artwork guy. And so, we're looking for some cool artwork for Monsterfest 2017. Now what I'll do is, like I normally do for these packs, the first pack, I will go over the order of a pack, just in case you were new to Magic the Gathering. And once we do that, then we'll kind of go a little bit more swiftly. Although not too swiftly, because we do want to check out some art. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to have is a bunch of commons. Now, I don't know, with this set having flip cards, if there's 8, 9, or 10 commons in a pack. Occasionally there will be a foil card in the packs, and if there is, then there's one less common card in the pack. The common card is denoted by a black set symbol, as shown here. On this card, we have sort of a thorned crown. If this were an uncommon card, which there are 3 of in each pack, then this set symbol would be silver, and if this was a rare card, it would be gold. If it was a mythic rare card, it's going to be sort of a reddish-orange color. Let's go through it and see what we've got. So we have Crushing Vines to start things off with. Erdwall Ripper. I'm actually going to read what some of these cards do. Okay, so choose one destroy target creature with flying or destroy target artifact. Okay. Erdwall Ripper, haste. Whenever Erdwall Ripper deals combat damage to a player, put a +1/+1 counter on it. Okay. Oh, that's pretty. Right there. That's our first one that... What a beautiful foil that would be. Oh, wow. That's just gorgeous. Beautiful card. Stormbound Geist. Can only block creatures with flying. I'm serious. I have no idea what's even in this set. I thought before I got on here, yeah, maybe I ought to get on Star City Games or TCG Player or something and look up and see what's in the set. But then I got to thinking, you know what, that might distract me from the artwork, because then I'm going to start thinking about the dollar value of the cards, and I really don't want to do that. I don't want to be like every other Magic the Gathering channel out there that opens packs of cards. I want to be different. So here we are, with a 5-mana cost flying first striking griffin. That seems excessive. Spiteful Shadows. That's interesting. So he's got like a sword stabbing into his shadow, but it's not actually stabbing into his head. Very interesting. Whenever enchanted creature has dealt damage, it deals that much damage to its controller. Okay. Somberwall Dryad. Gorgeous card. Oh, wow. Would you look at that? That is absolutely beautiful. Absolutely gorgeous. Heavy Mattock. What does that do? +1/+1. If it's a human, it gets an additional +1/+1. Okay. Fling! That's always a fun card. Dude, check out... I mean, he's literally lopping this dude's head off. His head is coming towards the viewer. That's insane. Wowie zowie. Again, great use. Just like in some of the previous sets of contrasting colors here, you've got this nice blue streak right down the center, and you've got this kind of orangey red on both sides. Really, really great combination of colors right there. Wow. Creates a lot of movement, too, because you kind of see this orange, and you sort of ignore this middle section, and you're like, hey, here's some more orange. Holy cow, it's a dude's head. Drog Skull Captain. Now, I'm going to turn this down for just a second and count the commons. Okay, so we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 commons. Okay, so theoretically, and again, I don't know the pack order here, if we have 8 commons, we have 3 uncommons, it puts us at 11. Then we'll have a rare, which will put us at 12. One of the cards is a land, which leaves 2 cards left. I think one of those is a flip card, and one of them should be a foil card. So we'll probably see a foil card in this pack. Drog Skull Captain. Oh, man. The artwork on this is insane. I mean, just... It's unbelievable. Every time I see, like, these kind of, like, spectral paintings, it's really, really just gorgeous. Absolutely beautiful. So, man, that's not too bad either. 3 mana for a flyer that's a 2/2, and he gives all of your other spirits +1/+1 and hexproof. That's pretty darn good. Common or uncommon number 2 is the Strangleroot Geist. By the way, that's the uncommon set symbol. I told you it was kind of silver. So there you go. Okay. Undying. I think we saw that ability in Avacyn Restored. I don't recall. When this creature dies, if it had no +1/+1 counters on it, you return it to the battlefield with a +1/+1 counter on it. Okay. So that's not too bad. You basically get a 2/1 creature for 2, and then you get him again, and it becomes a 3/2 creature. That's pretty good. All right. Third uncommon. Skurzdag Flayer. I think we saw him on the... yeah, here he is. Over... here on our deck box. Okay. That's cool. Skurzdag Flayer. Sacrifice a human to destroy target creature. Nice and flavorful. Alright, so behind this, I don't know what it's gonna be, to be honest with you. It might be a rare, it might be a flip card, it might be a foil. I'm stumped. But we'll see here. It's gonna be the rare for the pack, and it is an actual rare because it's gold. It is a Thraben Doomsayer. So let's see what this is. It's 2/2 human cleric for two white and one. You can tap him to put a 1/1 white human creature token onto the battlefield. He has something called Fateful Hour. Don't know what that is, but it says, as long as you have 5 or less life, other creatures you control get +2/+2. Oh, excuse me. Yawning. That's kind of an interesting mechanic. I don't know how useful that would be in game format. I guess it's one of those things where it's like you don't necessarily put him into the deck because of that ability, but it's a nice ability to have just in case that condition ever gets met. So, kind of neat. Alright, so behind this, there's 4, maybe 5 cards. Here, it looks like 4. Let's see what's behind this. I think it's a flip card. Never mind. It's an advertisement card. So there you go. There's an advertisement. What's behind the advertisement? Is it, that's a checklist card. Okay, what's behind the checklist card? Is that a flip or is it a foil? It's a flip card, I think, because I don't see any foiling on it. Okay, I do not. Loyal Cathar. Again, beautiful, beautiful artwork by Ryan Pancoast. Gorgeous use of that just hint of purple and pink up here in the sky against this very neutrally toned remainder of the frame. Really, really nice. Alright, so the Loyal Cathar is a flip card. When Loyal Cathar dies, return it to the battlefield transformed under your control at the beginning of the next end step. So what does it transform into? Transforms into the Unhallowed Cathar. Alright. So it's like he's now on the other side of that that window trying to get in. Pretty cool. He's a 2/1 that can't block. And behind the Unhallowed Cathar, what do we have? We have... Well, it's an uncommon foil. It's a Farbog Bone Flinger. So it's a 2/2 zombie. It costs 5 mana. That's a lot. When Farbog Bone Flinger enters the battlefield, target creature gets -2/-2 until end of turn. That's not too bad, I suppose. I mean, it's really a one-shot deal for a 2/2, but if you can figure out a way to flicker it in and out of the battlefield with, like, a Deadeye Navigator or something, I guess it's okay. All right. So there we go. That is pack one, my friends, of Dark Ascension. And we are well on our way now into this fat pack. Let's get to it, shall we? All right, let's go to a wolf next. Am I not going to be able to open these from the top? Because that would really just irritate the snot out of me. Not that I mind opening cards from the bottom, but... I'd like to know that they weren't tampered with in some way and glued back together. Hey, look, it's the same pack we had last time. Crushing Vines. That'd actually be kind of funny. Skillful Lunge. Wowie zowie, would you look at that beautiful spear. I mean, that's gorgeous. Man. Torch Fiend. Not a huge fan of the art, gotta tell you. Not a huge fan of the art. It's a little too red for me. A little too monochromatic. Grave Purge. A lot of stuff going on here. Just a ton of stuff. You could look at that for 10-15 minutes and probably find new stuff. Any number of target creature cards from your graveyard on top of your library, and draw a card. Okay. Bone to Ash. Okay. Rack with Madness. That's one of those weird perspective shots. You're sort of standing above this guy as he's standing on the edge of a building, so I guess it'd be sort of like so. They actually should have done this horizontally. It would have made more sense to do it that way. But it's still a very, very cool perspective. I like it. Very nice.
Alright. Target creature deals damage to itself equal to its power. Okay. Kind of an interesting idea. Divination. That's a strange picture for divination. I don't really know what's going on there. And there's a table over here with a candle on it. But what the heck is this? Is it like a body that's been covered up? I don't know. Very strange. Somberwall Dryad, once again. How many are we in now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so this is number 8, so, oh wow, we got another foil, looks like. I think that's right, let me count it again.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Yep, so we're getting either another foil or there will be two flip cards in this pack. Towergeist. Again, another one that would be nice and foil with that lamp right there. I bet you that would look really cool. Deadly Allure. Target creature gains death touch until end of turn and must be blocked this turn if able. Another Skrzdag Flayer. What's that rare going to be? It's going to be the Zombie Apocalypse. That would have been a cool one to end on. Zombie Apocalypse. Let's see what we got. It's a sorcery. It costs three black and three. Return all zombie creature cards from your graveyard to the battlefield tapped. Then destroy all humans. That's not too bad. Not too bad, man. Pretty darn cool. Behind that, we have an advertisement for a very strange... I don't know what set that's from. Interesting. Almost looks like Amonkhet. Or something that could be Amonkhet. Of course, that would be weird, because... this set was 2012, I think. Maybe early 2013, something like that. So, who knows? Let's see, what's behind this? We have our flip card behind this. It's an uncommon flip this time. We have the Afflicted Deserter. At the beginning of each upkeep, if no spells were cast last turn, transform Afflicted Deserter. Turn him over so we don't see the foil, and we'll flip it around like that. He turns into the Werewolf Ransacker. It's a 5-4 werewolf. Whenever this creature transforms into a Werewolf Ransacker, you may destroy target artifact. If that artifact is put into a graveyard this way, Werewolf Ransacker deals 3 damage to that artifact's controller at the beginning of each upkeep. If a player casts 2 or more spells, transform Werewolf Ransacker. Okay, not too bad. And we have a foil, I think. What's it going to be? Is it a foil? Yes, it's a foil, not a flip. So what do we have? We have a common foil. Oh, sweet! The Skillful Lunge. Wow. So, let's pull. There we go. That's pretty cool to get both of them in the same pack. Man. That's beautiful. Wow. That is just absolutely stunning. Yeah, I know it's not worth anything, but man. Look at the art. Let's look at that a little closer. Kind of. So shimmery and shiny. Very, very, very cool. Great sense of movement and flow in that artwork as well. Just gorgeous. Alright.
Oops, hello. Don't bend the card, please.
There we go. Pack number 2 is down. Let's move on to pack number 3. By the way, if you're wondering why I'm putting the cards back in the packs, I tend to do that if this is one of your first times watching one of my magic openings. I do that to protect the cards until I get to the point where I'm going to sort them into a binder for set-making purposes. Death's Caress is the first common card that we've got here. Doesn't really look like a caress so much as Death's Smother, but hey, whatever. Alright. Gruesome Discovery. I don't know if it's really a gruesome discovery. I mean, yes, she obviously found someone dead, but he's not, like, mutilated or anything, so it's really more of an unfortunate discovery. I like this mechanic, too, by the way. Morbid, if a creature died this turn, something happens. In this case, so the target player discards 2 cards is what this would normally do. If a creature died this turn, instead that player reveals his or her hand, you choose 2 cards from it, and then that player discards those cards. I love the fact that it's just any cards. So, kill one of your opponent's creatures, or have one of your opponents kill one of your creatures, and then steal your opponent's land that they have so desperately been wanting to play. Nearheath Stalker. A little undying critter. Thought Scour. Oh, that's beautiful. Target player puts the top 2 cards of his or her library into his or her graveyard.
And draw a card. I love me some mill.
Absolutely love it. That's a creepy picture, by the way. Let's zoom in, just so you can have some nightmares like myself.
There you go. Enjoy seeing that one. Okay.
Alright, what else we got? Wild Hunger. Alright then. Where's Jennifer Lopez? Nice cube when you need him. Take care of that Anaconda. Highborn Ghoul. Doesn't look very high, Bor. Looks like he's coming out of the ground, to be honest with you. Talons of Falcon Wrath. Feeling like a Lady Deathstrike vibe on that one. Gather the Townsfolk. Let's do that. Let's gather those townfolk. Hey, it's got Fateful Hour. If you have five or less life, put five of those tokens onto the battlefield instead. I like these mechanics, man. This is so cool. Where it's like, you do something, but if something else has already happened in the turn, then you do this thing instead. I love that. It's so cool. It's kind of like, what was it, Revolt, I think? I think Revolt was what Aether Revolt had, and then Raid, I think, is the newest one from... from Ixalan. So cool. I love mechanics like that. By the way, that's common number 8, so are we... Okay, so this one will not see a foil card. We do have a Falcon Wrath Torturer, though. Falcon Wrath, the ancient flying sacrificed creature, was a human. Put a +1/+1 counter on. Alright, what's that first uncommon? Warden of the Wall.
Warden of the Wall. Excuse me.
I really need to stop filming these videos at like 11:30 at night. But that's alright. It needs to be done. And I like to go through these things and have myself some nice artwork before bedtime. Makes me happy. Okay. As long as it's not your turn, Warden of the Wall is a 2/3 gargoyle artifact creature with flying. That's kind of cool. There's our third Skurzdag Flayer. Can we make it a playset here within 4 packs? That'd be cool. Jeez. Briar Pack Alpha. That's pretty cool looking. 3 Wolf Moon, almost. Need to draw a little moon back there in the background. When Briar Pack Alpha enters the battlefield, target creature gets +2/+2 until end of turn. Okay. I guess you could flash him in and make him a 5/5 to block something. That's pretty cool. What's our rare going to be? It's going to be Fiend of the Shadows. Fiend of the Shadows. So we have a 3/3 Vampire Wizard for 2 black and 3, has flying. Whenever Fiend of the Shadows deals combat damage to a player, that player exiles a card from his or her hand. You may play that card for as long as it remains exiled. Interesting, because there's no mechanic here. Let me finish it first. Sacrifice a human, regenerate Fiend of the Shadows. Okay, so normally when you see something like this, it's... That card remains exiled for as long as whatever this thing is stays in play. But here, that's not part of the wording, so that when the card gets exiled, it's just gone. But here we have something that says you may play that card for as long as it remains exiled. I don't know of a single card in Magic the Gathering that can pull a card back from exile into the game. So why would that wording even be on there unless they were planning to print such a card in the future? Very interesting. Little thoughtfulness for you guys out there. We have behind this, is it another advertisement or is it a token this time? It's a token. It's a token. It's a wolf token. Aw, doggy. Hi. What the heck is that? That's our flip card, and it's a mythic. Okay, cool. I'm not going to complain, but I'm curious to see what it's going to be. What is it? Huntmaster of the Fells. Huntmaster of the Fells. Okay. Hey, it's a mythic and it's a flip. That's pretty darn cool, right? Okay, so we have a human werewolf who doesn't look much like a werewolf here. For 1 red, 1 green, and 2 colorless, he's a 2/2. And whenever this creature enters the battlefield or transforms into Huntmaster of the Fells, put a 2/2 green wolf creature token, onto the battlefield, and you gain 2 life. At the beginning of each upkeep, if no spells were cast last turn, transform Huntmaster of the Fells. Just out of curiosity, does anyone else find it a little morbid, and yes, I know that's a mechanic, that if this guy really is a werewolf, he's covering himself in a wolf pelt? I find it a little bit strange, but, you know, that's just me. Could just be me. Who knows? What's he transform into? No reason to turn a thing over, because... there's no foil behind him. So what's he transform into? He transforms into the Ravager of the Fells. It's a 4/4 werewolf with trample. Whenever this creature transforms into Ravager of the Fells, it deals 2 damage to target opponent and 2 damage to up to 1 target creature that player controls. At the beginning of each upkeep, the player casts two or more spells last turn, transform Ravager of the Fells.
Okay. Not too bad. Then we have
Then we have a mountain and a hand. All right, so let's put this back. Hey, that's pretty darn cool. First mythic. We didn't get any mythics in the Avacyn fat pack, if I remember correctly. I think that was a mythicless fat pack. Maybe we'll see another mythic here. Maybe we'll see two more mythics. Wouldn't that be fun? I'd love to get a foil mythic. That'd be cool. Can I please access the cards? Is it too freaking much to ask to get into the pack so that I can get to the cards and show the nice people out there some really cool artwork for Monsterfest? I just, you know, just asking. Good night. Urf. We now return to your regularly scheduled program. Here's a Shriekgeist. I've heard of this card. What does it do? It's a 1/1. Whenever Shriekgeist deals combat damage to a player, that player puts the top two cards of his or her library into his or her graveyard. Okay. It's also chipped at the top. That's annoying. To have a perfectly brand new card chipped. Hollow Hinge Beast. Let's take a moment to take a look at this artwork. We're in Monsterfest, and that is a cool-looking monster right there. Oh, that's awesome. Again, great use of almost monochromatic colors, but we get a little bit of blood staining right around the teeth area there. Very, very, very cool. How big is this guy? He's a 5/5 beast for 5. That's about as generic as you can get. He's basically a big grizzly bear. There's another Spiteful Shadows. How about another Erdwall Ripper? There's a black cat with what would be a very, very cool set of eyes were this in foil. Target opponent discards a card at random. What happened to random discarding? That's such a fun mechanic. I grew up with Hypnotic Spectres, Him to Turex, things like that. Oh, it was so cool watching your opponent cringe when they're, you know, the thing they didn't want to have discarded was the thing that got discarded. So fun. Man, such fun mechanics in some of these older sets, and they just don't exist anymore. There's another Fling. Midnight Guard. Wow, that's pretty. That's really well done. That's actually almost got a bit of a rainbow effect. If you take a look at the, obviously you've got all this dark blue over here, and then you've got this really bright section here. But if you look at this, it kind of goes like sort of this orange to red to sort of, kind of a yellowish color down through a green, through a little bit of a turquoisey color, down into a blue down here. So kind of a neat little rainbow fade going on right there. It's pretty cool. Alright, so what are we at? We're at 7. There's number 8. Chant of the Skiffsang, or Skiffsong. Who knows? Weird. -13, -0. That's a pretty hefty negative right there. Okay, and behind that we have... Oh, no foil in this pack. That's okay. We have a Highborn Ghoul, though. What's our first uncommon? It's the Deadly Allure again. Have you been allured yet? How about with the Hollow Hinge Spirit? Oh, perspective card. Gotta love these things, man. You are in the card. Oh, it's so cool. Man, that's just beautiful. Absolutely fantastic. Again, probably a great-looking foil. Man, can't believe how cool this art is. Wait a minute now. Hang on. Okay. I was thinking that was our third uncommon, because the next card's gold, and you don't see too many gold uncommons. But here we go. Stromkirk Captain. Other vampires you control get +1/+1 and half first strike. Not too bad. What's behind this? It's going to be a rare or a mythic. Let's be a mythic. It's not a mythic, it's a rare. But that's okay. Counterlash. Okay, sounds like a counterspell. It's an instant. It's 2 blue and 4. Counter-target spell. You may cast a non-land card in your hand that shares a card type with that spell without paying its mana cost. That could be fairly powerful, to be honest with you. Especially, I'm thinking in this block, you know, if you had like a Gristlebrand or something, man, throw that puppy onto the battlefield for free. Not bad. There's the divination picture I'm used to. All right. And then behind that, what do we have? We have a checklist, and then we have a land. Do we have a land? No, we don't have a land. We have a flip card. Where's my land? Am I not getting land in this set? I guess not. Whatever. Scorned Villager. It's basically a land of War Elf for one extra mana. At the beginning of each upkeep, no spells were cast. You transform the Scorned Villager into the Moonscarred Werewolf. That's actually pretty cool. It goes from a 1-1 that adds 1 to your mana pool to being a 2-2 that adds 2 to your mana pool. That's pretty cool. I like it. I like it a lot. 4 packs down, 5 to go. Got ourselves a cool mythic flippy card. I don't remember what it is. It's some kind of a werewolf. Come on! Oh, I swear. I really should not have cut my nails before I did this. There we go. There we are. We have breached the pack. Can I have the cards? I mean, honestly, jeepers. Break of Day. Creatures you control get +1/+1 until end of turn. If you have 5 or less creatures, those creatures are also indestructible. If you have 5 or less life, sorry, those creatures are also indestructible. Pretty cool. Gruesome Discovery. I love the artwork on that. I mean, it's a beautiful card. I just don't like the name of it, because, as I said, it's just not that gruesome. I mean, yes, the guy's dead. It's unfortunate, but not gruesome. If it was gruesome, maybe he'd have, like, some entrails or something, like, falling out this way. I don't know. I love the painting, though. I mean, I don't love the painting, but the way the art is done is just very, very nice. You can see the pain in the lady's face, so it's just a beautiful piece. But it shouldn't be named Gruesome Discovery. Anyway, that's my rant. Screeching Scab. My scabs usually itch, but not screech. If they started screeching, I'd be a little confused. Another perspective shot, by the way. Near Heath Stalker. Last time I saw this, I didn't really notice it, but I'm seeing it now. This kind of looks like just the way that the artwork is done. Very reminiscent of, like, box art from old NES and SNES games. Has that sort of very, almost cartoonish, but not quite, like cartoonish, but you're trying to make it real kind of appearance to it. Very interesting. Very interesting indeed. Near Heath Stalker. Bone to Ash. Rack with Madness once again. Crappy looking Divination. Sombervold Dryad. That's our 8th common. Come on, give me an uncommon behind this. Yes! That means we get a foil. Tracker's Instincts. You know, I don't know. I am not an expert. However, if, by chance, the thing that I was tracking left glowing footprints in the ground, I think I'd probably be a pretty good tracker. I don't know. Just throwing it out there and you know, just checking. I think I'd be pretty good. Could be wrong. All right, anyway, let's go. That's the first uncommon. Uncommon number 2 is a Farbog Bone Flinger. He's not foil this time, but that doesn't make him any less weird. Blood Feud. Target creature fights another target creature. That is insanely expensive. 6 mana to do that. But it is in red. I mean, normally something like this would be in green, and it might cost you like 3. But I guess in red, yeah, it'd be a little more expensive. Alright, we're approaching our rare card. Let's hope it's a mythic rare. What do we have? Nope, it's just a regular rare. We have Feed the Pack. That's pretty gross. We have an enchantment for 1 green and 5. At the beginning of your end step, you may sacrifice a non-token creature. If you do, put X 2/2 green wolf creature tokens onto the battlefield where X is the sacrifice creature's toughness. That's not too bad. Not too bad. Behind that, there's probably an advertisement, unless they're going to give me a token. No, they're not. We have a Hell Vault, though. That's pretty cool. And behind that, what is there? There's a checklist card. Yep. And we have a flip card behind that, I think. Yep. It's an uncommon flip. It's another Afflicted Deserter. Let's just flip him over in case you don't remember that He turns into a werewolf ransacker. And we have a foil card. What's that foil going to be? It's going to be... Oh, it's common. That's okay, though. A hollow hinge beast. All right. Not that great of a foil, but it does help me see there's a little bit of extra color down here that I didn't see in the non-foily version. This one... this tickles me. In this one, just because it's foil, it almost looks like he's about to be beamed up into a spaceship somewhere. They don't know what they're about to get, do they? Alright. It's not going to be another local yokel. It's going to be some nasty beast up in that ship. Alright, what do we have left? I got four left. Four left, half an hour of time left on my camera. I think we can make it. I certainly hope so. Okay, we're almost in. Come on, baby, we can do it. Grr. Just can't get a freaking grip on the pack. Why don't you just tear them open, Christopher? Because I need the pack to put the cards back into, that's why. So I have to be at least kind of gentle with them. As much as I dislike them, I do have to be somewhat nice to them. Alright. Favor of the Woods. Torch Fiend. That's interesting. New one. Artful Dodge. Target creature is unblockable for one mana. That's pretty good. Grave Purge. Break of Day. Ooh, that's cool. Really love that use of pinks and blacks together. Always one of my favorite combinations of color. Let's take a look at this. We haven't looked at a piece of artwork in a while, so that's really, really nice. Very cool. Blind Skeleton, or Blind Zombie. Brought to us by Svetlin Velenov. Svetlin Velenov. Can't block, and he has Undying. Okay, it's all right. What are we at now? We're at, that's six. Fires of Undeath, seven. Eight is the Falcon Wrath Torturer. Let's see an uncommon. Can we see an uncommon? Nope. There's a Dawntread Elk. Aw, it's a freaking elk, seriously. I guess that's not too bad, though. I mean, he's a bear with a special ability. There's our first uncommon. Warden of the Wall, again. Followed by Faith's Shield. Target permanent you control gains protection for color of your choice until end of turn. Okay. Fateful Hour. Each permanent you control gains protection to color of your choice until end of turn. Pretty good for one mana. Third uncommon is the Immerwolf. Now that's a unique piece of artwork right there. It doesn't match. I mean, like, it doesn't match something like this. This has almost a realism to it. This is very... very much old school fantasy. It's by Therese Nielsen, by the way. That's probably why. What's a rare going to be? It's going to be the Ghoul Tree. It's a 10/10 zombie tree folk. Wow. For one green and seven, cost one less to cast for each creature card in your graveyard. That's actually not bad. I mean, in and of itself, the mana cost versus the power toughness is pretty darn good. I mean, eight mana for a 10/10 is equivalent to a 4 mana for a 5/5, which is not bad. And then it costs 1 less to cast for every creature card in your... That's... I'd play that card all day long. That's pretty darn freaking cool, man. I like it. Hey, we have a token. It's a human token. And what do we have behind that? Is it a flip or a checklist card? And then we have our flip card, which is going to be a Loyal Cathar, which again flips into the Unhallowed Cathar. Okay. Three packs left. Three packs left. Oh, yeah. Going back to sword. Come on. Ugh. All right. Stormbound Geist. First common. Screeching Scab. Favor of the Woods. Bar the Door. There's that really sweet piece of artwork that was on the player's guide. That is just fantastic. I mean, absolutely absolutely wonderful. I mean, again, another Ryan Pankost piece of art. It's so, I love pieces that tell a story. And this is, I mean, one shot right here. It's like a frozen moment in time, but it tells so much. I mean, you can see the desperation on the face of the one guy that's facing you. I mean, you can kind of see it in the musculature of this guy here, sort of trying to hold that bar in place, this guy holding it in place, maybe sliding it into place, the door splintering up here from the hands that are trapped in between them as they try to push the door open. Unbelievable. Just fantastic artwork. Absolutely wonderful. Bravo. Bravo. There's a Forge Devil, by the way. Does one damage to target creature and one damage to you. Another fling. What are we on? This is number 6. There's another Sightless Ghoul. Still an amazing piece of artwork. That's 7. That's 8. The Ovenwald Bear. Now we got a 2/2 bear for 3, so I gotta read it, because, I mean, seriously, Grizzly Bear, come on, guys. He has Morbid. When Ovenwald Bear enters the battlefield, if a creature die this turn, put 2 plus 1 plus 1 counters on target creature. Okay, so if you had something die, you could technically have a 4/4 for 3. I think that's not bad. Let's see an uncommon. Please give me an uncommon. Nope. El Guad Inquisitor. Not a fan. Gotta be honest with you. Not a fan of that artwork. There's the first uncommon. Curse of Thirst. Huh, that's interesting. I wonder, I guess this is a type of, shucks, what am I thinking of? A type of, a card type. Jeepers. It's late. Can't think. So, I'm just reading, because it says it deals damage to the player equal the number of curses attached to him or her. That must be a thing in this block, is curses. I don't know. I'll bet you there's probably one for each color. Mystic Retrieval is our second uncommon. Third uncommon. Altar of the Lost. We saw 3 uncommons we haven't seen yet. Maybe we'll see a rare we haven't seen yet. Let's see what the rare is going to be. It's going to be Curse of Echoes. Well, there's another curse for you. Look at that. So for 1 blue and 4, we have an aura curse, enchants player. When enchanted player casts an instant or sorcery spell, each other player may copy that spell and may choose new targets for the copy he or she controls. Okay. That's not terribly good, but it's not bad either. There's a human. And behind that human, we have a checklist token. And what do we have behind that? We have a flippy. It's a mythic. It's another mythic flip. Holy goodness. And it's an artifact. What is this? Elbrus the Binding Blade. Okay. So for 7 mana, that's a pretty expensive artifact. You get a piece of equipment. The equipped creature gets plus 1, plus 0. That sort of sucks. When equipped creature deals combat damage to a player, unattach Elbrus the Binding Blade, then transform it. And it transforms into a big friggin' demon. Okay, well, that would explain the 7 mana cost. A 13/13 legendary demon with flying, intimidate, and trample. What does intimidate do? Is that fear? What would used to be called fear, where you can't be blocked except by black and artifact creatures, I think. Whenever a player loses the game, put 13 plus 1 plus 1 counters on Withengar Unbound. That's kind of cool. So it's sort of, in some ways, so basically, in and of itself, he's a game winner if you're playing like draft or standard or something like that. But he's also designed for multiplayer games, obviously, which is kind of cool, because, I mean, you've got this ability here where when somebody loses the games, this dude gets a plus one, or 13 plus 1 plus 1 counters. So he was designed to stay on the field. So that's pretty darn freaking cool, man. Sweetness. Two mythic flip cards in one fat pack. I am really enjoying this fat pack much more than I like the Abyss and Restored, even though Abyss and Restored is very near and dear to my heart. I have to admit, I do like getting mythics. I really do. Now I'd like to see a foil mythic in this one. That'd be really cool. I don't know if it'll happen, but might be fun. Thought Scour. I'm a Tome Scour kind of guy myself. Same casting cost, doesn't give you the card draw ability, but you get to make your opponent mill 5. So, Wild Hunger. Skillful Lunge. We've seen that in foil. Haunted Fengraf. That's a pretty piece of art right there by Adam Paquette. Wow. Man, that'd be a great playmat. That's beautiful. Add 1 year mana pool. Sacrifice Haunted Fengraf, return a creature card at random from your graveyard to your hand. Cool. Favor of the Woods. Man, that bear's got a lot of favor in those woods. There's another Jawn Tread Elk. Reap the Seagraf. What a strange name. What is with this graph stuff? Just out of curiosity. I didn't make it into the set, so if you have any idea what all this graph stuff is, feel free to let me know, because I really don't want to have to go look it up. Scorch the Fields. I didn't expect to see a big dragon in the set. I gotta be honest with you. That's a surprise. That's a real big surprise. Okay. Destroy target land. Scorch the Fields deals 1 damage to each human creature. That is common number 8. Do we get an uncommon behind this so we can get a foil? Nope, we don't. We get a divination instead. There's our first uncommon, though. Tracker's Instincts. Diagraph Captain. I've seen that guy played in some zombie decks before. Death Touch. Other zombies get +1/+1. Whenever a zombie dies, target opponent loses 1 life. Pretty cool. Is that number 2? Yes. Number 3. Skurzdag Flayer. We have a playset of Skurzdag Flayers. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm excited. I don't know about you guys, but hey, I'm going to find something to put this guy into my whole playset. Modern deck. I'm going to make a modern deck out of this one guy. Never made a modern deck before, but we're going to do it. What's behind him? Give me a mythic. Give me... I'll take a rare. That's fine. Ooh, sweetness. Man, would you look at that artwork. Boy, that's awesome. Okay, so let's read the card first. Increasing Savagery. Sorcery. It's 2 green, 2. Put 5 +1/+1 counters on target creature. If Increasing Savagery was cast from a graveyard, put 10 counters on that creature instead, and you can flash it back for 2 green and 5, which means you can cast it from your graveyard. That is pretty darn sweet, but let's take a look at that amazing, amazing artwork. That is so cool. Wowie zowie. Who did it? Steve Prescott. Really cool. Unbelievable piece of art right there. Wow. And that, my friends, is what this whole Monsterfest opening of these packs is all about. Is to find artwork like that. Oh, so, so sweet. And we get a token, too. We get a human token. Is there a checklist behind this? No. There should be a checklist card behind this human token, but there's a flip card instead. Does that mean we get 2 flip cards? Or did I miscount? Hang on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's 9. 10, 11, 12, 13. And 14 is the flip card. So, someone explain to me what the hell's going on. I don't know. But let's see what the flip card's going to be. That's another Loyal Cathar. Which transforms into, shockingly enough, I know it's gonna be different this time. Nope, it's not. It's the Unhallowed Cathar. What the hell is behind this guy? Oh, it's a land. Okay. I'm so unused to seeing lands in these packs. I think we've only seen one other land that I was like, whoa, did they give me an extra card? I've had that happen one time. I got 2 rares in one pack. It was a pack of Amonkhet. I opened it during one of my Amonkhet League games. I don't remember what the rares were. Both of them were junk, but it was still pretty cool. Could I please? And it wasn't like they had replaced a common with a rare. There were actually 16 cards in the pack. I counted them up after I got done, because I was very confused. Alright. Last pack of the Dark Ascension Fat Pack. We're going back to Sorin. Lord of Innistrad. What do you think he's going to give us? He's first going to start out by giving us a Torch Fiend. And then a Grave Purge. And then a brand new common we haven't seen yet called an Nephalius Seakite. It's a 2-3 flyer with flash. Wild Hunger. Ray of Revelation. Another Divination. I think we've got at least a place out of those now. Rack with Madness. Somberwall Dryad. Heavy Matic. No foil. Faith's Shield. Niblis of the Urn. Okay, what's behind this? Is that our... Okay, so that's the second uncommon. Third uncommon is Altar of the Lost. And the final rare, unless there's a rare flip card, what's this one going to be? The Requiem Angel. So it's a 5/5 flying angel. One white and five to cast. Whenever another non-spirit creature you control dies, put a 1/1 white spirit creature token with flying onto the battlefield. It's not too bad. Behind that we have a wolf. That must be the only two tokens in here, is a wolf and a human. Actually, the wolf comes from Innistrad, so maybe human is the only Dark Ascension token. I don't know. What's behind the wolf? A checklist. And then we have our flip card, which is going to be a... It is a rare flip, so we actually get to end on a rare flip card. Mondronin Shaman. Again, gorgeous piece of artwork by Mike Sass. Is it Sass? Sass? S-A-S? It's going to be Sass. I thought it was S-A-A-S. So that would make it Sass, but it's Sass. All right. Wow. Really, I love the use of pinks in there. Pinks and kind of bluish, purpley, little bit of dark or grays and blacks. Just beautiful. Anyway, it's a rare. Human Werewolf Shaman. One red, three colorless, gives us a 3-2 critter. At the beginning of each upkeep, if no spells were cast, we transform it into Tovalar's Mage Hunter. What a strange name. Wow. It's a 5-5 werewolf. Whenever an opponent casts a spell, Tovalar's Mage Hunter deals 2 damage to that player. At the beginning of each upkeep, if 2 spells or more were cast, transform it back into the Mondronin Shaman. Very, very cool. I bet that eyeball would look really sweet in foil form. Very cool stuff. And I gotta tell you, man, that was a nice, nice fat pack. I know, probably didn't see $20 worth of cards. And that's okay. You know, I think for the whole fat pack, I think I only paid like $40 anyway. But, I mean, I gotta tell you, just the amount of cool artwork like that we saw in this set is so worth opening these things. You know, I was kind of debating, to be honest with you, opening any of these fat packs, especially getting over to the older ones with them, you know, potentially increasing in value. I'm like, do I really want to do it? But, oh, man, jumping into these things, seeing some of this beautiful artwork really, really, really makes it worthwhile. And I got to tell you, I'm really looking forward to our next and final fat pack, the Innistrad Fat Pack. This one is very, very cool. And we'll be unboxing it next Monday. Join me then. For right now, though, we'll call this one done. I want to thank you very much for watching. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done so already. Also, as a side note, I do have a Patreon account. If you feel so compelled, please feel free to check it out. Even a small donation really, really helps to increase the quality and the quantity of the videos on this channel. If you enjoyed this video, I would highly encourage you to step over there and check it out. For a simple $1 per month donation, you can make a great, great difference in this channel and my ability to give you really good quality content like this. Again, though, thank you again for watching. It really means the world to me. If you have any comments or questions, again, drop them in the comment section down below. I hope you will, too, because this was a great fat pack. There was a lot of cool stuff in here, and I had a heck of a lot of fun, and I hope you guys did as well. Join me next week as we unbox this Shadows over Innistrad, or not Shadows over Innistrad, we already did that one, this original Innistrad Fat Pack. Maybe we'll find ourselves a foil Liliana of the Vale. I don't know, but time will tell, and I hope it tells us some good things. For right now, though, I will bid you goodbye. Thank you very much for watching. I really do appreciate it. God bless you all. Have a horrifically wonderful rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.